this second Sunday of Lent, I want us to reflect on the theme, remember your mountain experience. My dearest friends, today's liturgy, especially the gospel, presents to us the experience of the transfiguration of Jesus on the mountain. Jesus was transfigured in the presence of his three disciples, Peter, James, and John. Interestingly, the liturgy also presents three individuals, three stars of the Old Testament, and three of the New Testament. The first reading of today from the book of Genesis, chapter 12, verses 1 to 4, tells us the call of Abraham, one of the stars of the Old Testament. Abraham had a mountain experience in his relationship with God. And on the mountain of Transfiguration, we were told that Jesus was seen discussing with Moses and Elijah. Moses is also another star from the Old Testament who had a mountain experience of the Lord. And likewise, the prophet Elijah. He also had his own mountain experience with the Lord. And in the New Testament, we see this experience given to the three closest disciples of Jesus, Peter, James, and John. My brothers and sisters, it is interesting as well to know that in the Bible, mountain always symbolizes a place of encountering God, a place of having a life-changing experience, a place of revelation. And so it is not by coincidence when Jesus took his three disciples to the mountain, as related to us in the Gospel of St. Matthew today, Matthew chapter 17, verses 1 to 9. Dearest friends, we all have our own mountain experiences, moments when we experience the awesomeness, the overwhelming presence of God in our lives, an experience that is beyond the ordinary, an extraordinary experience, moments of consolation, memorable moments in our spiritual life and relationship with God. These are the mountain experiences that you and I often experience in our spiritual life. But there is a reason for this mountain experience. The gospel of today started after the Lord had made a prophecy about his passion, death, and resurrection to the disciples, and how Peter stood against that prophecy. And the Lord bringing them to the mountain was to give them an experience that will strengthen them when that moment of passion, cross, death of Jesus appears in their lives. So the mountain experience was to serve as a great memory in difficult times. That is the purpose for that mountain experience. Dearest friends, it is also worthy of note that during that transfiguration of Jesus, we heard Peter exclaim, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three tents." Peter was no longer interested in going down the mountain. He wanted to prolong the mountain experience. He He wanted to remain on the mountain, but the Lord had to come down with them. My dearest friends, also, this is a lesson for us all. As long as we are in this world, the mountain of experience will not last so long. After that experience, it is to lead us into our everyday life, to strengthen us in carrying our crosses every day to follow Jesus. It is not a place for escapism. Just like some people feel a troubled world will not be good for them and they want to flee, or flee from families and friends. But the mountain experience is to strengthen our difficult situation. So as we celebrate this second Sunday of Lent, we are invited to pay attention more to one of the essential elements of this Lenten season: prayer life. It is in the context of prayer that we can truly have this mountain experience. On this second Sunday of Lent, I ask myself, how far, what improvement have I made in my prayer life, in my relationship with God? The Lord is always there. He wants to be close to us. He wants us to experience the profundity of His presence, His awesomeness in our lives. Let us draw near to the Lord in this season, so that He will strengthen us and help us, so that in our everyday life, the experience of the Lord on the mountain will strengthen our faith in following Him, despite the difficulties, despite the challenges, despite the crosses of life. Let us ask the Lord to grant us this grace of a prayerful disposition, that our Lent will truly be a spirit-filled one. May the Lord bless you